Gut, der Sturgeon Campaign, Sturgeon Class, also very beloved submarine class from mid to late Cold War. And also a Hunter Killer. It's a submarine changer. Yeah, the campaign briefing, the campaign you can find, typical place, Sub Voodoo. What? Why did he open it 2 to 1? What the heck are you doing? Yeah. And here, sub command, if you go through this list, you will find tons of mission, and there will be also the Sturgeon campaign conversion. And for people that want to play with some challenge, because it's not a 6-8-8, it's a Sturgeon, use the 85 version, the upgrade one. If you want even more challenge, use the older one, the 75, but you might have not stuff like wire-guided torpedoes, which is crazy. I mean, you not often play Dangerous Waters or Sub-Command without wire-guided torpedoes.
Play Dangerous Waters or something.
And yeah, using torpedoes without wire is a complete different story. Sturgeon.
You have done excellent work in your POM cert workup. The
Yep.
Halifax police report that your Liberty crews also set some new records. On your transit home for a short final Liberty, you must provide ASW services by acting as a target for a surface action group in the operating areas. Of course, you are to conduct simulated torpedo attacks, so you should maintain the upper hand. Give them a chance. They're only skimmers. You are ordered to conduct exercises with a SAG consisting of the Underwood and the Arleigh Burke. Conduct simulated attacks from periscope depth. Be careful not to actually fire a weapon. Don't let the range get less than 4,000 yards, because in a real attack you might be detected. The SAG is located northwest of your position and is proceeding to the east-southeast. Proceed northeast to intercept their track. A more direct approach risks running aground. Continue simulated attacks until otherwise directed. There are reports of an Akula in the area. Be alert for intruders and do not allow yourself to be detected. Comsublant will send a message for completion of the exercise. You should continue the practice torpedo attacks until receipt of this message. This ASUW practice might be valuable during your deployment.
Okay. Subrocks. Subrock. Yes, what is it for MK48 ADCAP even? Yeah, it was really. Yeah, I mean, you can. It was coming into service, I think, 87 or something, but yeah, we are some top secret boat already having it. Yeah, let's run with one Harpoon, one Subrock, two MK48s. Stores. Yeah, I mean, for utility, give me one UUV, one Slammer. You know? No UUV, so what? Huh? Is it eating my. What? It's eating my torpedo space, stop it. Those UUV stores are eating my torpedoes, okay. It's done. I don't want those UUVs, keep them. I guess a UUV is not an option, perhaps it was not available. Yeah, harpoons too. I want a full package of harpoons, you never know. Yeah, anti-ship missiles, nah. Let's remove them. I don't think those. We have 4 tubes here, 4 harpoons, 4 subrocks. Two mines. Have everything on board, you never know. I mean, you can use those mines offensively. I think you can deploy a slammer mine behind you when you chased. I don't know, I never did it. But I think they are basically torpedoes that will home into something that comes close. It is a torpedo mine. So the mine in a classical sense, but I'd never used them properly. Good, yeah, we have our orders, let's go. Let's look at our beauty. And it looks like a smaller 688. But it was also quite successful boat, quite advanced boat. Okay, yeah, active intercept immediately, tell me where this happened. Okay, 330, change course, 330. 337, let's run straight at them.
Come left to course 337, helm high.
This thing is equipped as a towed array, right? That's over the street. Yeah, working towed array, beautiful. That is a big thing, yeah. Yeah, who is somebody operating the sonars? Is the towed array hitting the ground?
Retrieve the starboard towed array, helm I. Make turns for 5 knots, maneuvering on.
Yeah, I think it's crazy, they said don't come closer than 4,000 yards, you might get detected. That's 2 nautical miles, man. I never would go, yeah, I would never go that close 2 nautical miles to an enemy destroyer. Yeah, in case you don't want to die. That is way too close. It's a joke distance. This is a true contact. Okay. Maneuver, I need to see which one is a true one. This is quite close, right? How the heck is it that so close? But it's not on a hull. Okay, zero is a true contact. Man, that's really fast.
We have a new contact, bearing 356, designated Sierra 1.
Okay. Beam it so the towed array can check it out. What is the. Oh, that is on the towed array. Ah, okay, the towed array is lagging. Mm-hmm. Good. Yeah, looks like the spherical on the Sturgeon is definitely a different story than on a 688. But we have contact, quickly give me, what is a typical, whoa, what is a typical, are this US ships, right, they're just, we're training with US ships. TPK 8, what is for example having something else? Yeah, TPK-8 seems to be the number we need. But that doesn't sound right. Looks a bit too slow. Perhaps we're tracking a submarine. Nah, it was too loud for a submarine. They have all TPK-8. That's not normal. Why is that? Something is wrong here. That is not normal. But it's a false contact. Oh, no, yeah, okay. Wait. What is the problem? Why is he not changing course? Ah, he is. 270. Yeah, that must be a false contact. There's something that close. Something is... That is not normal. Yeah, India is a true contact, but it always stays in relation to us. What the hell is it? Yeah, this is my own sub. I don't know what this is, but it's I'm tracking here my own sub. It looks like the total race behaving somewhat different from what I know. Give me active intercept. Active intercept is the best information we have currently. It is 337. Everything else is absolutely unimportant. That is a true information we can rely on.
Come right to course 337. Hell my.
Even zero. Right. Okay, let's aim between. That is 356. Period.
Come right to course 356. Hell my.
Yeah, yeah, that's a shadow. If you move, the total rate picks you up. It looks somewhat different from what, but it looks like on a 688, it is better filtered out. Now we will simply run until we establish contact on the on the spherical array. That is also telling you that you're getting close to a surface ship. Everything else is, it is basically impossible that a surface ship will hear us first. But I'm on a Sturgeon, I better save. So, but Sturgeon is still a good boat. I mean, it was one of the best submarines of the Cold War. And at least Hunter submarines. Was basically the father of the 688, I would say. Hmm.
Con sonar, I have a new contact, bearing 039, designated Sierra 2.
Oh, goddammit, what the heck is here going on?
Con sonar, I have a new contact, bearing 036, designated Sierra. Three.
Interesting. Let's maneuver somewhat. To filter out what is true, what is wrong here. A lot of stuff happens here without me noticing. Crazy. How fast this went. Yeah, sometimes you have really special special water conditions. I think I remember this mission for being very... Okay, that's in the middle is a first contact caused by us. That is as well a first contact. No, wait. That I can't hear. What a total array, man! Jesus Christ, man. Worst moment to stop it. I need to... Yeah, that's definitely a false contact, but here... Which one is a true contact? This here.
Sonar, I have a new contact, bearing 283, designated
Sierra 4. Oh, this is... Fishing boat, yeah, I'm pretty sure this is a fishing boat. That is indeed a fishing boat. Or a spy ship. Vishnia. That is indeed a fishing boat. Ah, here. Confirmed. Okay, so that's not that really interesting. More interesting is what the VFS. Yeah, what is this here? Where's my cruiser? Hello? What? Why there are so many Vishnias or fishing boats around? I mean, nah, there is a... What the f... Like you are telling me here. There is a confirmed Oliver Hazard Perry class confirmed cruiser position 60, bearing 62. Sierra 2, Sierra 3, one contact, merge them. Ah, TMI is deactivated. I mean, sure, why not? Yeah, first classified as Oliver Hazard, Oliver Twist, Confidence High, Elliot. Don't bomb it. Good, give me TPK on Master 1, frequency 50, TPK 8, speed 17, TMA solution 17, fix it, where's the ruler here, zoom in, target is going like this. Intersections, look at the intersections of taut array and... Whoa. That would be too close for... Wait. Yeah, that is what I meant was cluttery. The section happened here. That's the intersections we're looking for. But it is not... Bubsy, speed it up. Give me 10 minutes. It's impossible to establish a solution at the intersections. There's a big bearing arrow. Intersection here. That looks real. Okay, now we're getting something. Something like this at this. And it turned. It turned. Intersection. It is turning, so you can't get a proper stack, but that's not important. That is somewhere at least. So we need to get. close to the ray hit. Okay, that is definitely first contact was here. Last sphere sonar hit, last towed array hit. Yeah, it looks like he's really going like this. He's going away, that is not funny, so I need to get into 2 miles. Damn it, that's... But again, let's auto crew take over. But it's a joke, right? My Sturgeon can't even... I mean, if I run that fast towards this... Yeah, great. Who the heck am I supposed to reach them? Yeah, this mission is randomized, but it's based on the original of Sonar List, and yeah, they sometimes really screw up the missions. And what the heck am I supposed to do here? Okay, we need to get into 4 nautical miles. I mean, that is... Okay, I can get this towed array in.
Retrieve the starboard towed array, helm eye.
Get the port array out. The port array is better at resisting speed.
Make turns for 15 knots. Maneuvering eye.
How much do I need to make? 16, so if you make 17, we can make it. Is it still running? It is running 17, not 16. But TMA changed the solution. But yeah, the solution is correct. You see those intersections here? They are really important. Those intersections tell you. If you even have a single 2 lines by towed array and sphere or hull sonar, you might already fire a torpedo, because you know approximately the position. And if you fire a torpedo, everything changes anyways. Nobody stays on course when a torpedo is in the water coming for him, so. But normally, an enemy ship can't evade that fast, it is not an aircraft. Yeah, now it's screwed up because you're maneuvering. But it's fine, it's okay. It's exactly. Yeah, you have been counter-detected, man. It's just fucking hell, man. Really, Sonar List, they simply designed a box, I guess, and placed a random waypoint or whatever. Intercept, have fun. No submarine would approach like this. God damn, man, this is... Yeah, but we had some luck. Let's restart it and it's fine.
You have done excellent work in your palm. You're ordered. There are comms.
I mean, you can play the mission and sure, you can go far away. Like, but it would take 3 ages. Then you can cavitate speed. And then you can come back closer. But this would take a lot of time. Better reload it. It simply ended up as a bad... But I guess you need to immediately full speed towards them. I guess. Okay, let's immediately check the active intercept. Active intercept is coming from zero, so the mission changed. Last time this was coming from elsewhere.
Come left to course zero.
Speed up to 10.
Elmi, make turns for 10 knots.
Give me toll. Yeah, that's fine. TMA will do myself in the beginning. Follow the active intercept until we. That's typical Sonalist mission. It's really typical Sonalist mission. I don't know. They are not that really good at writing briefings. They wouldn't have won a prize for writing briefings, definitely not, or for mission design. Okay, it looks like they're now coming at us. But in the beginning, they also were coming at us and then they maneuvered. I mean, this teaches you also to react fast. You can only work with the active intercept. We wasted a lot of time doing other stuff while they evaded, while they disengaged from us. You can simply by active intercept in your brain already via what is going on. They are not coming to us, towards us. They're driving towards us. This is like deviation to starboard. And we are currently, and now we will go on a lead pursuit, which is something like 20.
Come right to course 020, helm I.
Only the active intercept you can also workshop before you use it. Okay, we have something here. Overlapping two contacts. One is a cargo ship. Or whatever. And I tell you, the other one is a sub hiding there. Do we have a 50 hertz frequency? Yeah, look at this guy. This is a 60 hertz. Oh, suddenly this boat has a 50 hertz frequency. This is the Akula. Where is that? I got you. He's hiding below some cargo ship. My friend, forget it.
Sonar.
Ah, wait, first we should maneuver.
Designated Sierra 1.
I don't even know if this is a true contact. But we see it here. There's indeed a true contact. Here on the history you see when we maneuvered it okay. But we can confirm it. Ah, that's interesting. That were two overlapping. Ah, that is interesting. So this thing is true. It is not somebody hiding. That is a cargo ship at. Okay, and this is. What is this? A sub tanker. What the heck is a sub tanker? Wait, what? Oh, Sonalist. Hey, let's place two ships exactly so it's in the first mission. so players would be irritated. So they place two pointless ships in relation to you. Or was it really everything back? What the heck? Something wrong with why I see two targets. Did they place two times the same ship? Yeah, but they can't. I mean, that must be really some lucky or unlucky accident. This is two times the same ship. is the 50 hertz frequency? I mean, how the hell can this be the same ship if this is carrying a 50 hertz? Okay, it's a fishing boat, and so what the heck are you telling me? So you need to update it, what, on the sturgeon? Aha, you need to update it on the sturgeon, okay, yeah, okay, now it makes sense that it's a fishing boat or some whatever ship. Everything fine, okay, problem resolved. Let's check active intercept. Receiving a ELF in my headphones. Yeah, we are in 20, they're moving slightly towards right. Should be now fine, but better safe. What the heck am I receiving in my headphones? Okay, speeding up.
Come right to course 040. Helm I.
Something new appeared. What the heck? Fishing boats all over the place.
Cannot be completed. Report for debrief.
What?
Make turns for 5 knots.
Maneuvering. Oh man, the sturgeon is absolutely different. On 10 knots, it is completely washing out sphere contacts. We went below 2 knots, below 2 nautical miles. Look at this. Look at this. And I didn't see it on the spherical because we were running 10 knots. What the hell? I contact this 2 nautical miles away. Yeah, but. Wait. You report me, this is a Vishnya or... Oh, fucking hell, man. Okay, looks like I really require some training with the sturgeon, so it's good.
You have done excellent work in your ComCert workup. Your order, the comms.
That is really hard. So 10 knots is blinding completely the spherical.
Make turns for 7 knots. Maneuvering on.
Man, this is absolutely crazy. I run right into those targets.
Come left to course 000. Helm I.
Yeah, but I remember the first mission is somewhat strange. They have absolute. I don't know, Zonalis is really good at choosing the worst missions. The first mission is really, really strange. You have some strange sound conditions in the water. You have some strange shallow waters there. It's basically like a exponential function with the sound. You hear nothing, you hear nothing, you hear nothing, you hear extremely like this. I don't hear anything, and then whoosh, it gets up, something like this. It is, I don't know. The speed of sound profile looks normal, but there's something strange as the ground. I don't know. The first mission is really some shenanigans going on there. So, first contact, or it's myself. But can it be that far away from... Yeah, it can be. Okay. Okay, new contact, that is the first contact, that is the true contact. What the heck? Why am... What? That is a true contact. Why is it myself? some shenanigans going on here. Or is it indeed a false contact? No, it is getting louder. Yeah, it can be only a false contact or a friendly submarine. Okay, I don't care. Nothing I'm concerned of. Yeah, something changed, something they're behaving now differently. Could be that they're going now to...
left to course 3-4-0, helm I.
That they're going a different course. Yeah, you need to update sometimes the screen, otherwise it shows you old information here. Okay, but no sub, so it might be a it is simply a 50 hertz frequency, but... And why are you filtering out the other stuff? I mean, if you're only picking up 50 hertz, it could be everything, right? Ah, this... uh-huh. That's always this case. Oh, if you have LCD, if you have an old... I only buy old monitors, so I can now you can see it everywhere. I do the brightness trick, the contrast trick. Yeah. Okay, that's one of our guys, right? Oh. Now they're going to left. Okay. Yeah, let's turn to 300 then.
Come left to course 300. Helm I.
So the Raymark picked them up from here. They're picking something up. What? Interest. But yeah, this is good training. I mean, you will learn about the limitations of your boat. Okay, we're picking up something up here at that might be one of our targets. Why are you not seeing it? Okay, track it.
Con sonar, I have a new contact. Bearing 357, designated Sierra 1.
Why the heck? What can tell this? Yeah, this computer is really advanced. This Sturgeon computer. Okay, that is a Hazard Perry. Hazard Perry, TPK 8. Running 8 nuts currently. Yeah, let's activate TMA. I don't have time here to do everything. Let's try to get a towed array hit in order to quickly locate what the distance is. Here it is. Hit. Hit.
Con sonar, I have a new contact. Bearing 353. Designated Sierra 2.
Oh, that thing is close. I see. Here it might be somewhere. Distance is reported to be. Hello, ruler. Speed was what? 7 or 8 something currently. Yeah, the problem is you can't touch this. 7,000 yards. Yeah, that is close. Basically 3 miles plus. That might be sense. And then you can immediately launch a torpedo. Could now launch a torpedo. You have approximately location of the target. So we are basically in range of a periscope attack. Let's simulate it. We want to immediately attack this target. On the other hand, we want to track the second target, right? Okay, let's do it properly. But I don't want to go anything closer. Yeah, TMA take over. Handle it. The course is somewhat to be believed. Two ten or something, go parallel.
Come left to course 210.
Yeah, it's 220. Something like this. Good.
Come left to course 220. Yeah. LI.
What is this here? Another warship. Good. When we turn, we will realize which one is it. And then we have both warships. Then we will go to periscope, confirm targets, attack. Good. Then we can plan it. Better safe if something goes wrong. Check TPK. Targets are still at 8 knots. Can somebody confirm? Alpha is confirmed. But Alpha is moving now. Is it because we are too fast? Slow down to a really slow speed. Yeah, 4 knots.
Make turns for 4 knots.
It's currently the target is moving towards starboard. Which indicates that. Here, this is a true target. Yeah, you need to update it. Okay, yeah, whatever. So I was already wondering why is it two Hazard Perrys? That makes no sense. Discourage.
Retrieve the starboard towed array, helm I.
Good, whatever. F1 target, let's go PD.
071 feet, dive I.
Point towards the target. And they're going again back, okay. Come to 30.
Come right to course 0.
Lead pursuit.
Helm I.
Prepare tube. I'm not about to fire, but we can already get presets done. Let's make sure that we hit those surface targets with a floor of 100 feet. Perhaps even 50. Looks like 250 is the limit for some reason. Okay. Whatever you say. Ah, because of the death, right? Yeah, that would be a problem, yeah. Uh-huh. Good. Let's train preparing harpoons. This is a subrock. Oh, wait, what is this? This is a harpoon. Run to enable yards. I mean kilo yards, right? 5 yards would be a bit okay. Would be quite short. But this isn't this tube 3 a subrock? Tube 4 is subrock. 3 is MK48, why is load a harpoon, I said. Okay, we are in optimal firing. We can't even get closer, otherwise we will endanger us.
Make turns for 3 knots. Maneuvering up.
We are at PD. Up scope. Confirmed. Oliver Hazard Perry, photo, down scope. Confirm range. Range something like 5,000-6,000 yards. Perhaps even closer. So we need to watch out. Okay, is it confirmed? I mean, mission status. What is the approach? Approached it, I assume. Something with the. Yeah, you need. This was something with the periscope depth here, right?
Make my depth 0, 6, 8 feet.
Bye bye. Approach goal complete. Continue with your mission.
Like I told you, many of those custom subs have other periscope depths, but the game still requires you to set it to a certain depth. Okay, and where's the others? The other thing? Don't see it. Upscope. What is this flying there? Good. Lost 30 seconds maximum. Periscope, okay, yeah. Where's the other ship? Spotted. Mark it. Give me bearing, where is it written? 340, downscope, 30 seconds over. 340, okay. Disengage from CQ from red.
Make turns for 5 knots. Maneuvering on.
Make my depth 0, 7, 1 feet. Dive I.
Okay. Ticonderoga. Yeah, indeed. From where did you know this? Who helped me here? That looks really like a moon. And the mast looks a... Two VFS. This is the Ticonderoga, I believe it. Stop it. Okay, starboard 45. Distance 7000. Oh, let's say round it up 8000. It is lagging behind and following the hazard parry. Okay, first make sure that we don't run into too close.
Depth 0, 7, 2 feet. Dive
by. Let's see if we can pick it up on the tort array.
Con sonar. I have a new contact. Bearing 3, 4, 1. Designated Sierra 3.
Okay, beautiful. Oh.
Stream the starboard tort array. Tell mine.
Oh man, this thing is coming right. Nah, come on, don't tell me stories. Okay, bearing 341. Confirm it on the active intercept. Did it stop pinging or what is the problem? Thank you. nicht. Das Towed Array.
Retrieve the starboard towed array. Helm on.
So. Okay, thank you. Okay. It's indeed not. It might be Iraq. Yeah, okay, confirmed. Yeah.
Con sonar. I have a new contact. Bearing 353. Designated Sierra 4.
All right. Seventy knots. Show me Master 2. Yeah, the one is very old. That is an active intercept one. It is useless. But once I confirmed that, yeah, this is an Iraq Barco. Fleet flagged 1, flagged 2. I don't care. Both die the same. Yeah, I knew it. Something was different. It's a must. Who? Yeah, that is a must. Perfect must. Yeah, who put me this? Who left this system on Ticonderoga? I was thinking some odd secret auto crew, but no. Yeah, this, you see this double mast here. That is what we are looking for. Okay, let's start the attack run. This would be basically a perfect.
Continue with your mission.
This would be a perfect attack on both. Okay, but that's not required. And we will now continue to. Scope. What is absolutely missing is quickly slide the periscope towards your targets, towards your masters. Okay, that is a tick on the Iraq Borg. Cargo ship, Hazard Perry. Good, let's go parallel. Let's see, distance is increasing.
Come left to course 100, helm I.
Yeah, sometimes there's shenanigans going on. Looks like you activate some secret propulsion, I don't know. Yeah, in sub-command there's sometimes shenanigans going on in the 3D vision. In the true 3D vision. I can't tell what's happening there. Now it disappeared. Ah, here. Yeah, this is faster than normal. I don't know what he's doing there. But mission is done. Simply have. Let's see if we can find this. Let's go deeper.
Make my depth 100 feet. Dive I.
What? 1 0 1 0.
6 8 feet. Dive
I. Understand. Make my depth 0 0 feet. Yeah. Because if we get detected, the mission will still fail, I think.
Zero feet. Dive
I. So, Akula, we are looking for. Yeah, this is way too cluttered. Simply look for 50 Hz frequencies. Same. Yeah. No Aquilas here.
Sonar, I have a new contact, bearing 026, designated Sierra 5. Consonar, I have a new contact, bearing 065, designated Sierra 6.
See, even the TMA is not focusing on those dots. He's focusing on the intersections. You see those beautiful intersections here? This is not important, but here. Between toroid and sphere or whatever this is. And sometimes you hear people saying, TMA, he's getting solutions way too fast. No, he isn't. If you establish contact with a spherical and a toroid array, you can basically tell you only need two sonar hits, and then you can tell, look at this here and this here. Sure, I mean, it's having a bearing error. So let's take this and this here. It almost gives you a connect this intersection with this intersection. You might have speed, course, distance immediately. Triangulation is quite powerful. You can even see that it makes this master one. Master 2. Master 2 has no toroid array hit, or what is the problem? Toroid array was which color? I always mix them up. Toroid array is red and white is spherical or hole. Okay. And he's missing what? Now he's getting information here. Okay. Yes, Mike helped this guy also now is to. This thing is far away, it seems. Blue is what? The whole array would, and white is sphere. Okay, yeah, I always mix those colors up. Computer calculate and then give me a trigger. Is it too faint? Theory, nah, he isn't tracking it. Come on. I see it. Sturgeon. Track it. No, Mr. Goddamn 60s, eh? Technology. Jesus Christ. Disengage from red. Sturgeon! Is he tracking it already, or what is the problem? I don't see a tracker letter here. This Sturgeon has problems. Perhaps he likes the black line more. No, it's not black. Okay, whatever. Not working currently. Here. Look at those intersections. I mean, I don't know if the solution is correct, but we might need more data, new data, and it's because TMA is put off, he will now correct it. And here you can ask this item, this here for example. Has a bearing error, yeah. If you have three things like this, you see they are really beautiful, the intersections are beautiful lining up. This not. And if you focus on the dots, you won't notice this. Yeah, because it's impossible. Either he turned, sure. He came towards you and then he maintained distance. Possible. And that's also, focus on the last dots, you see, intersection, combine them, you have all data you need. Yeah, look at this, he's really a stacker. But yeah, 20, I mean, it's really, this thing is running, of course, straight, but if you have a submarine or whatever that's maneuvering, this thing here, I never look at it, almost. This is important if you don't have those intersections. You're only working with a single array, then you might use those dots to, but even with, if you have speed, like I said, if you have speed, because if you don't have intersections, you definitely need speed. It's your most important value, and then you also start to look at those things here. That's exactly what I would do as well. Put it over the intersections. I mean, he doesn't know speed, we know speed. We can check it even because we have him on the waterfall. Speed is currently 17. Autocrew is not taking the data from the waterfall, from the demon for some reason. But yeah, I mean, he has a fine solution. See, this simply, there's no other, this is a possibility, but it doesn't make sense with intersections. This makes sense. Intersection, and all speed thing, all speed indicators aligned with the lines. Perfect solution. But you could also do it with three or two. Could it even do with a 5-minute solution? And sometimes that's way too fast. TMA is not even about fast. I mean, if your data looks valid, you can establish a solution, like I said, with this and this. Let's only take those two things. Intersection. Look at it. here. Sure, you have more bearing error, it could be, but you see the speed is not, if you take the first intersection, and yeah, you see, I'm looking at those two things. It is, if you, you only need two data entries and you have your solution. This would be a solution in 1 minute. This, sometimes you see people, man, work, oh, 5, 10 minutes. Oh yeah, I calculated. No, that is absolutely not required. And TMA, is the auto crew is doing something similar. And yes, they can come up with a proper solution in 1 minute. A player can also do if he knows what he's doing. What, this 1 minute time, I think a minute they provide you a solution. A minute they provide you data. Could even do it with 30 seconds, would be also fine, but period. Course, distance, everything established. Sure, if you have no speed, you can drag the ruler. Let's see, but if you, then of course becomes, you get a bigger error. Because you don't know, it could be something like this, could be something like this. That's why speed is so important. Could be in this range. But still, I mean, if you launch a torpedo, it doesn't care. You don't care if the target is going like this or this. You know, the general direction is this. You will fire a torpedo into this direction, you will hit. That would be basically the possibilities, if you don't know speed. But it's still enough to kill a target with 95% probability. And if you have speed, you see now it's fixed. It is basically coming down to one solution. And I'm not talking about the exact degree, nobody needs a degree. TMA is quite easy if you, at least for subs. It is often looking complicated. I need to do it on the, but it becomes. It is also good training you on other aspects, not only submarine warfare, but it is also quite helpful for understanding things, perhaps in your. In other aspects, perhaps even in your. Why is he putting that so far away? Autocrew, what the heck are you doing? Here are the intersections. But he knows, got some secret. See, they sometimes even screw it up a bit. I think the target is close, I mean, I don't see a reason, but yeah, because he thinks that it's running 15 knots, which means, which doesn't make absolutely sense. 15 knots would be even closer. But yeah, okay. I mean, he just arrived with a cup of coffee. give the man or the woman some time. And it's even, yeah, now he's worked it out. The great thing about playing this game is also that you need to do a lot of in your head, and somehow it helps your imagination. And sure, it depends on what you do. You might not need it, but science knows that if you train your secondary, I don't know if you can translate it one-to-one into English, we call it secondary skills, basically stuff like math, geometry. You might, you know, often you hear people saying, I don't need stuff like this in my job. That's true, but they don't teach us at school. Only for the sole reason that you might need it. They also teach it because it is known that this improves your thinking in multiple areas, perhaps even non-math areas. And this game is pretty good at training it a bit. It's basically the Dr. Kawashima of imagination. Dr. Submashima. Kawashima. You know, there was this game for Nintendo of brain jogging, brain training. For such for those little Nintendos. And this is also about this game. It is, if you never did TMA and stuff also like this, watching the screen and understanding what is happening. Why is this line looking at this with bearings? Why is it looking like a onion on the head? Like a sweetheart. Yeah, look, let's take a look at the Akula. And yeah, in order to make it easy, I always look at 50 Hz frequencies because Russian subs have 50 Hz frequencies. And yeah, we already spotted this. This was some, I don't know if this is somebody hiding there, but I don't think so. On the other hand, that looks strange. Let's keep it for the moment. Ah, interesting. The false contact and the true contact are coupled together because they, that is also seldom that this happens. We need to maneuver in order to declutter them. False and true contact always keeps the same distance from your, basically from the toad array, and they are basically both at the maxima coupled together. And now they will declutter, become a bunny, then they will become a cat, and then they will become a, what? Okay, that's enough. And the true contact is again, is he right over us or what? I see you awake. Yeah, it might be that we are, but we are deep below, that should be fine. Let's go a bit deeper just to be safe. I think I saw awake.
Make my depth 150 feet. Bye bye.
Okay, that is the true contact. You see, here's a history on the sphere.
Mission accomplished. Report for debrief.
This will be the true one. This will be start moving with the toad array. When the toad array starts to move. I had already moved, but I don't see it. Whatever, mission done. That's not maneuvering, okay. Resume waypoint follow. Now I get that problem, okay. True contact and the first contact will move to the right. Because it always stays in relation. Are we moving? Okay, yeah, we move. What? Why cost 90? Ah, okay, but yeah, okay, I get it. Because the waypoint is on 90, not 100. Okay, yeah. I was thinking we're moving 100 like this. No, everything will move right, this thing and this thing. And this will stay true. So now Akula here. Okay, yeah, mission done. ASV exercise over. the simulated attacks. See if was there a Russian sub somewhere. Okay, but it was kilometers away. If it is slow, we won't hear it. But it was here and observed us.
You are directed to leave port to monitor an operational test of a new Russian anti-air missile in the Western Barents Sea. Although operational security is important, local surface traffic is heavy. Maintain a radar and visual search for commercial and pleasure craft until clear of Long Island Sound. There is a Russian AGI just outside the 12-mile limit collecting information on U.S. ship movements. If you are detected, then you can expect extra vigilance by Russian forces protecting the missile test and possible additional Russian submarine escorts. The AGI may also vector waiting submarines to intercept your transit and track you to the test area. There is an Akula reported in the area. Be alert for intruders and attempt to break contact without resorting to overt measures. Your primary goal in this mission is to break out into the open ocean without being tracked. Detecting the Russian AGI or any Russian submarines is a secondary goal. It will provide valuable intelligence, but it's not worth risking the primary goal to achieve these detections. If Russian units are detected, take action to avoid. Do not take offensive action against any ships.
Okay, but we will play this mission next time. I just wanted to. Yeah. Oh no. Yeah, but it should be fine, right? I mean. Yeah. I don't know if you. Aborting missions like this might change the dynamic nature. I don't think so. Okay, see you next time.